The .NET community has a serious problem, and it is stuff like this. This, okay? Broetry about software architecture that is total. Let me read you this story, okay? A few years ago, I was returning home from the company's Christmas party, but instead of sleeping in the van after a crazy and sleepless night, I reached out to my backpack and took out the Clean Architecture book from Robert Martin, aka Uncle Bob. I don't remember much of what I've read since I was tired. Like a laptop running on 1% battery, just waiting to shut down. What is this nonsense? It was in chapter 21, The Screaming Architecture, and he's gone, like, LinkedIn, yappy rubbish, and he's done an infographic, Screaming Architecture. Ah! It's Ted's Tech Show. Look at this. Clean architecture in .NET is about to change. Nobody even realizes. And this looks absolutely revolting. This screaming architecture is the key to building software that speaks for itself, all right? Intent is crucial. That's why my architecture uses your architecture should scream its content. This all happened on LinkedIn, like at the same time, all right? This guy, what is screaming architecture? This is LinkedIn broetry infographic slop. Every day, all day, coordinated. It has to be coordinated. Look at this. What does your folder structure tell you? Okay. I'm going to have to break this down. So I'm going to go into why following this pattern will get you in trouble just after this short message.
Do you like domes? Do you like trains? Then check out Dome Train, where famous YouTubers, Microsoft MVPs, and Microsoft staffers doing a side hustle teach you everything you need to know about .NET. Visit dometrain.edanderson.com or check the link in the description for this particular Dome's curated list of the best courses on Dome Train.
So the origin of this latest push for this by the LinkedIn influencers appears to be Uncle Bob, obviously, with his Clean Code book, chapter 21, I think, was it, based on the Twitter post. And this blog post, I mean, we can go through this, all right? Imagine you're looking at the blueprints of a building. This document, prepared by an architect, tells you the plans for the building. What do these plans tell you? If the plans you're looking at are for a single family residence, then you'll likely see a front entrance for your living. Yes, the architecture would scream house. Yeah, the architecture would scream library. What does the architecture of your application scream? You're not building a house, okay? And this is a nice analogy, but you would run the app, wouldn't you? If you run the app, you can see what the app it is. You don't need to look at the internal architecture of the software to know what it is. You just run the damn thing, okay? It has a user interface. But the problem with this is that this is a really old-fashioned way of looking at things. Uncle Bob is a legend, right? And his world literally started with punch cards, okay? The entire application has to work and run first time. You can't run it while you're developing it. The analogy here is also wrong. The first concern of the architect is to make sure the house is usable. It is not to ensure that the house is made of bricks. Actually, an architect has to make a house safe to live in and that it complies with various planning laws and codes, all right? Indeed, the architect makes pains to ensure that the homeowner can decide about bricks, stone or cedar later. This is not true, right? When you go to buy a house, you think, I'm going to have a brick house. I'm going to have a wooden house. I'm going to have a concrete house. I'm going to have a combination of all of these things before they design it. Listen to me. I've designed and got my house built here in Japan. And the first decision was what to make it from, okay? So this analogy, whilst useful, isn't quite right today. So what is right about this is when he says things like your business objects should be plain old objects that have no dependencies or frameworks or databases or other complications. This is correct, okay? This is right. But the infographic peddlers like this, the infographic guys, have got it totally wrong, okay? He's put this stuff underneath an API folder. Let's take this example, okay? And I will explain to you why for at least .NET backend applications, this is not a long run good idea. If you're building a React app and it's all JavaScript, you can stick stuff in feature folders. Nobody really cares. But on a statically typed back end, this will trip you up, and this is why. So this gentleman had an application folder like this. Application. Now, we can assume that these guys actually have dependencies on mediator, like this. So in .NET, namespaces are used to try, before they did implicit usings, okay, to try and create some sort of dependency separation tree. Now, the problem here is that if you think that everything for an order is under the application.order space, right? If you want to refer to a user within an order, which is highly likely, you've now suddenly just got a using application dot you dot user users in here, alongside your namespace, which is application dot orders. And now at this point, you've totally crossed the streams. You might as well just have everything in the application namespace. Otherwise, what's the point here? Let's also assume that you have some POCOs and some interfaces in here as well, yeah? Okay, so let's go order. Look, it's in my order folder, all right? Now, the problem here is that because everything is in the same assembly and the same namespace, you cannot share it with any other system in a technical way. This is a technical app, okay? It's software without dragging all of the other dependencies with it. So imagine that this was in an app, main app here. Now let's also add order controller here. It's screaming at me, okay? This is screaming architecture, right? This obviously has a dependency on MVC, right? So imagine there's another system, right? Let's call it this the mobile app, all right? Mobile. Okay, and I want access to the POCOs and easy stuff that runs on my mobile app, so I can communicate with the web app or the server or whatever. All right, can the mobile app take a dependency on this? No, it cannot, because there are things like MVC and mediator and all of this, and none of this is required, if it even works at all. All right, maybe a desktop app. You want to build a WPF or Avalonia app, you can't bring this in at all. This is absolutely useless. So because this is a technical problem, you're building software, this just does not work long term. You will find yourself with this big ball of shared namespace mud. And you don't need screaming architecture for a developer to know what the system does. The system will probably ask what it does in the name, like its order booking app or whatever. Okay. Let's say mobile, desktop, CLI, whatever. Okay. You've got all these different versions. The correct way to do this is to have an assembly called shared, right, with your POCOs, interfaces, and anything without business logic in it. All right. And then this can easily run on anything here. So in the shared library, if you actually have, okay, things that can be shared across different implementations of your app. All right. So we go shared. This will have a folder maybe called DTOs, which will have order in it. And this will be a nice plain POCO contracts with, I don't know, contract for the order service, something like this, I order service. This app is now more valuable because it's reusable, and the code that you write can be used across different presentations or frameworks, as Uncle Bob likes to say, of your app. You've written code that is portable and more valuable. If you try and spaff everything into a single folder, you can't slice and dice this, all right? They all share the same namespace. They'll all be in the same assembly. And you just have a big ball of mud. And by having, if you use assemblies and namespaces to split them up, there is a hard firewall here, okay? Where if this shared project is imported into another presentation mechanism for your application, you know that it hasn't brought an incompatible or unwanted implementation along with it, because they would literally have to add a build reference to the CSproj file, right? The other angle is that you can distribute this to customers, to clients, without worrying about losing your IP and your business logic, because you can reverse engineer DLLs, right? So this is a safe set of contracts. And if you have the contracts and the implementations separate instead of all in one big ball of mud, you'll be much happier. This LinkedIn infographic demonstrates this far clearer than my scribblings. But if all the controllers and the models and the views and the DTOs and database stuff is all in the same folder, okay, you can't distribute any slice of this without, well, you just can't. You can't distribute any of it. You can't move the DTOs somewhere else to share with another app or share with a customer or whatever. And you have a namespace that has a dependency on every other namespace in your app. Dependencies on the database, the view engines, MVC, God knows what. Even with this example, it's pretty clear. If you wanted to share the events with another application, you would have to, instead of just moving this events namespace into another assembly, okay, and none of the code would change because the namespace wouldn't change, you now have to dig out all of the events from each of these folders and move them into something else. All the namespaces would break because suddenly they'll all be under e-commerce.events. It's not reusable, malleable, high-value software at this point. Come on. So ultimately, guys, look, software doesn't need to speak for itself, okay? You're building a technical solution, particularly on back ends, that need to be client and reusable and actually valuable software in its own right that doesn't need to be constantly moved around and is reusable from day one. And that's also Uncle Bob's other angle, right? If you build software that's flexible, then it can run with different presentation layers. This stuff, okay, blog posts with screaming buildings on it, also has to stop, okay? This is not cool. You're just rediscovering domain-driven design, which is also written about, and screaming architecture is not an architecture, okay? It's just folder layout, right? And it's not good. For backends, it's not good for backends. Anyway, that's my point. Anyway, if you enjoyed that rant, it got a bit technical there. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Thank you very much for watching. See you next time.